So we start with some node, right? So in this case, we start with the node and you go, right? You go as deep as possible of the chosen root, right? So you go to the depth of this particular root. Now this root is chosen, go to the depth of that root. This root is chosen, go to the depth of that particular root, right? So starts with the, in BFS, that is depth first search, it starts with the root node and visits all the nodes of one branch as deep as possible of the chosen node. And before backtracking, it visits all the other branches in the similar fashion, right? So before going back, it visits all the similar, all the other branches in similar fashion, right? So what happens over here in this particular kind of DFS kind of algorithms, if I want to visit a particular node state, right? I keep on visiting to the depth of that particular node, chosen node. Suppose this node is chosen. I keep on visiting to the depth of that particular node. Sorry for this. I keep on visiting the depth of this. And I then again go back. Suppose it is a in-order kind of traversal. In-order kind of traversal. So DFS basically can be categorized in three types. That is in-order traversal, pre-order, and post-order traversal. So you all, everybody knows what these three types of traversals are, and you all have understood. I hope you all have understood the recursive in-order, pre-order, and post-order traversal. Right? So what happens in this particular traversal way is you go back to the previous level, right? You go back to the previous level and then visit the right child or something like that. Again, go back to the previous level. So that is something backtracking you are doing in this particular kind of scenario. So when you're basically recursively calling the same kind of visiting strategy on the previous node also, I do have a data structure which will help me to do this particular kind of task. That is a stack kind of data structure. So why do I use a stack over here is when I choose a particular node, I go to the depth of that particular node of one branch, right? And to go to the next branch, I have to get back to this particular node, right? So what is happening is whoever is coming last is going to complete its task first and then go back to the next level. So what kind of data structure would be suitable to do this particular kind of task? So whoever is coming last in the in this particular order is going to finish his task and go complete the task. So which kind of data structure would be best suited in this particular kind of application?
Stack.
Right. So stack is basically a last in, first out kind of data structure where the node which has entered into the stack last will finish off its visiting and then go back to the next level, right? So I can make use of stack over here for DFS kind of traversal, or I can make use of recursion. But if I'm not permitted to use recursion, I can use the stack over here, right? Now what happens in BFS, that is a breadth first search, you start with the root, or you start with this particular root, and then visit all the nodes of the current depth. So at this particular depth, right? At this particular depth. So can you tell me what is the depth of a tree? Yes, what is a depth of a tree? It is basically the height of a tree, right? So it is the max. So depth is nothing but the maximum depth of a binary or a binary search tree in the, like, the number of nodes from root down to the leaf node, right? Number of nodes from root to the leaf node. So how many number of nodes are there from root to the leaf node? That is the depth or the height of your binary tree, right? So now in BFS, you first start with the root and visit all the nodes of the current depth. So at this particular depth, there is only one node. So you visit this particular node before you move to the next depth in the tree. So the next depth is at, so this is your level 0, this is your level 1, 2 and level 3. So before you move to the next level, you visit all the nodes in this particular binary tree. So you visit 1, then you visit, go to the next level, go to the next level, visit all the nodes at that particular level, then you go to the next level, visit all the nodes at that particular level, then you go to the next load and visit all the nodes at that particular level. So somebody on Udaya, speech of your mic. This shows how attentive people are during the lectures. Okay. So BFS basically, that is breadthwise, you keep on visiting the nodes, right? You breadth first search, right? So BFS kind of traversal is also called as level by level traversal or level order traversal, right? So this is level by level traversal. So what you do is you visit a particular node, you finish off all the levels, all the nodes at that particular level, right? Then you go to the next one. So what is happening here? Whoever is coming first will finish off his task, right? Will finish off his task and then go to the next level. So which kind of data structure is going to be suited over here?
Queue data structure.
Right? What is queue? Yes, Mudaya. What is a queue data structure? Mudaya, Ahes ka class madhe?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, what is a queue data structure?
Queue is a P4 data structure. Like in
P4?
First in, first out implementation is done.
Okay. So now, for implementation of BFS kind of traversal, that is level order traversal, you will make use of a queue ADT. And for DFS kind of traversal, that is in order, pre-order and post-order, if you do not want to do a recursive travel, you will make use of stack editing. Now, what is the difference over here is, this particular stack is not a stack of integers or characters. This particular stack is a stack of nodes where every node has the data as well as the pointer to the left child and a pointer to the right child, right? And even in the queue is basically a queue of nodes where every all index of this particular queue contains a node and not an integer or a character kind of queue. So every node is having a data and an address to the next left and address to the right child. So your front queue as applicable, front and rear, initially they are pointing to -1. Have you understood the basic theoretical concept behind BFS and DFS and what data structures are applicable for these particular kind of traversals? Yes, class?
Yes, ma'am.
So, can anybody tell me some applications of BFS and DFS? Yes, can somebody just apply something like where your BFS can be used and where your DFS kind of traversals will be used? Because you all are learning this traversals, but where do I apply this traversal? What are the applications that will be using these particular kind of traversal? Or is it that I directly use DFS or I directly use BFS?
Ma'am, in spanning tree.
In spanning tree. What is a spanning tree?
means the shortest path between the two points we can find out by using this
Using which? BFS or
in graph
DFS?
in graph
No, no, but using BFS or DFS?
DFS
Show shortest path between two nodes.
in graph.
Okay. Okay, I will not come to that particular point because I have not yet covered graph, so I'll not take into consideration this particular application.
Last time we covered the graph,
Last graph to me, Shikla.
unweighted graph and weighted graph in other subject.
Okay. Discrete Mother Shikla also.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So basically, in minimum spanning tree, you can either use DFS or BFS. I will tell you why when we will start learning the minimum spanning tree of the graph. Apart from that, what can be the applications of DFS? Tell me the applications of DFS first.
Maze can be one application.
Exactly. So,
Like we have to find
huh?
one path, so we go into depth, and if it is
Yes.
not, then we come back one and then try another one.
Very good. So, path finding, that is finding the path in like if it's a maze kind of application, right? So finding the path is one of the application, that is you go to the depth and you just check whether there is a next path is there or no. And when you
Then in
again
GPS system,
GPS system for using DFS.
BFS.
DFS. No, I'm asking you all now only DFS. So path finding is one of the application. Very good. Next, only DFS I'm asking. So you go to the depth. Think what all applications. So Kalpesh thought in a good way that in maze I can apply this in order or pre-order traversal to find the path. Again, so you all know, I will come to this particular part of in-order properties also. So you all know that one of the property of a binary search tree is the in-order traversal of only binary search tree. Okay, keep in mind the in-order traversal of only binary search tree will give you a sorted array, right? Will give you a sorted array. So the nodes or the nodes that are visited in order traversal of binary search tree, not of binary tree, only of binary search tree will be sorted, right? We all know this particular property. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? So this is one of the important property of a binary search tree that the in order traversal of a binary search tree will give you a sorted array, that is all the nodes that are visited by the in order traversal will be in a sorted way. So the applications where sorting is required for mainly when you are scheduling the jobs basically. So based on its weight, right? If the jobs are being scheduled based on the weight of that particular job or the priority of that particular job, you can use this particular DFS kind of traversal. Clear? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now what are the applications of BFS? So one of the application is BFS. What do you do is you complete level by level, right? So you visit all the nodes level by level. So first level, this is there. Then at second level, two and three are there, right? So basically what is happening that in BFS, you are searching this particular BFS kind of traversal will give you the neighboring nodes also, right? Will give you the neighboring nodes. So basically when you have a networking kind of applications where you have to do search the peers of that particular network, this particular BFS kind of traversal can be used over there. Then also you can have applications in broadcasting also, where you pass the packets, so in computer networks. So if you see this particular applications of tree, they do have a lot of applications in computer networks also. Then again, one of the application that I told y'all was to find the neighbors, right? To find all the neighboring nodes, right? So in networking also, then if you want to broadcast a particular packet to a node or a particular location, so level by level, you can keep on broadcast. So broadcasting is one of the application. Then you can use in GPS navigation also. Somebody told this application, na? Nishant, tu sangitla hotas na?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So how GPS navigation system, this particular application can be used? So you can think these as your mini project ideas also. Implement a GPS navigation system or something like that also. Yes, how GPS navigation system, this BFS kind of traversal will be used?
Ma'am, it will trace the one point to another point through the BFS, and so we get a minimum path or the distance between the two points that we
exactly look at. So this particular BFS will help you to find the neighboring locations, right? It will help you to find the neighboring locations. And this particular path finding, or whether there is a path between this particular nodes, that can also be one of the application, that is pathfinding, right? So these are few of the applications of BFS and GFS, DFS. So going further, we will get into details of this. Have you all got a theoretical clarity of these two algorithms, tree traversal algorithms?
Ma'am, excuse me.
Yeah.
Ma'am, in one application also, we can use both, like according to user. If we are implementing a library.
Yeah, yeah, you can use both the algorithms. You can use according, depending upon your application, there might be scenarios where you may need to use both these things. That's not a problem. So I'm just focusing on the major application areas this traversals are. Hmm?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now let us get into the implementation part. So a few of the labs I have started with the DFS traversal, that is in order, pre-order and post order in a non-recursive way. And but a few of the labs have not yet been covered, but I'll try to cover that particular part in theory also. But before that, I will take the level order traversal, that is a BFS, that is breadth first search. Okay. So as I told you that in BFS, that is the level order traversal, we do use a queue data structure, right? So you will be having a ADT queue of nodes, right? So this is going to be your today's homework, right? This is going to be your today's homework. You are going to implement an ADT queue of nodes, right? So you all know how to implement a queue. There are functions, that is NQ, DQ. So NQ, how do we insert an element in the queue? Where do we insert an element in the queue? Yes, class?
At front point.
At front or rear?
At front. Mm-hmm.
Front ki
rear.
Visarlas na Adesh?
DQ front.
DQ?
Rear.
You take the element out from the front, right? Will you all be able to do this particular implementation, that is queue of nodes, the way we did implementation of a stack using array of nodes? Karta yeil ka tumhala?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm going to try it at home. If you all are having difficulty during the implementation, you can ask me during the lab. Okay. Now, if for example, okay, so you'll have an NQ and a DQ function. You might be having an is full and is empty function also. Before that, you need to initialize the queue, right? You need to initialize the queue. You will have to check whether the queue is full or whether the queue is empty. When the queue will be full, what is the condition when queue becomes full? What is the condition when queue becomes full?
Fair plus.
Yes, what is the condition when the queue becomes full?
Rare plus one is equal to size.
When your rare plus one equal to the size of the queue that you have defined, isn't it? Right? And when does your queue become empty?
Front equal to rare.
Front equal to
rare.
Rare, right? So you can say that queue is full. Okay. So here I'm not expecting you all to use a circular queue. You can use simple queue also. In this particular kind of application, there's no need of using a circular queue. Okay. So now how does this algorithm go? Right. This is a tree. So this is just a binary tree, not a binary search tree, but the same thing will be applicable on the binary search tree also. Only the insert function in both these cases differ. Okay. So this is a binary tree. So in level order traversal, in a non-recursive way, you have to pass the node pointer. Okay. So this is your P pointing to the root, right? You will read a QADT. So Q is of type Q of nodes. So y'all are going to do this as an homework. This is a Q of nodes, right? So in PFS, it starts with the root, right? It starts with the root. So you first print the data that Q is pointing to, right? So what you will do first is you will print the data that Q is pointing to. P is pointing to. Clear with this? So you have a queue of nodes also now. This is a queue of nodes, front and rear equal to minus one initially, right? Next, what do you need to do is, once you have printed the data of the root or the printed the data where P is pointing to, you enqueue that particular node, into the queue, right? You enqueue the node into queue. So this particular node has the address of its left child and the right child also, right? So you simply enqueue that particular node into the queue, right? So you have visited this particular node of this particular level, right? Now you have to check whether the queue is not empty. So because now whichever node you have visited, you have to check for its left child as well as its right child, right? You go to the next level. So how do we go to the next level? You check whether the queue is not empty. So queue is not empty, that means there is a node, and if there is a node, it might be having the next level, that is, it might be having the left child or a right child, right? So while your queue is not empty, are you all understanding what we are doing? Yes, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, once you have enqueued a particular node in the queue, now you check whether the queue is not empty. So while your queue is not empty, hello, me call back for the lecture model. So while your queue is not empty, right? So what do you do is, it's not empty your queue. What you do is, now you have to get this particular node and get its right child and left child, right? So what do you do is, you dequeue the queue, because we have to do the same thing recursively on all the nodes. Now it's not only on the root node, we have to do the same thing on the next level, next level, next level. That's why while your queue is not empty, what you do is you dequeue that particular node. So you dequeued that particular node from the queue. So P is pointing to this particular node, right? Now if your P is having a left child, so if your P is having a left child, right? If your P is having a left child, what do? You simply print the data of what? Of what? So P is over here. What do? How do you print the data, this particular data 3? So ithe 8 print zalela ahe. How do you print this particular 3 now? Sorry?
Please let me change it.
How do you print this particular 3? P is pointing over here. And this 3 is nothing but the data of P's left child. So can I directly say P's child's data? Can I say this?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. So once you print the data, that is 3 is printed, you enqueue that particular node into the queue. So what you have to enqueue? You have to enqueue. What do you need to enqueue? In the queue?
Yeah, you need to
enqueue. P's L child, right? So you enqueue P's L child in the queue. So now my queue content is 8. So I had dequeued this particular queue, no? So I have, what do I have? 3 over here, right? I have 3 over here, right? Have I moved the P's pointer? Have I moved P's pointer?
No.
Next, what do I need to do? I need to check. I need to check what?
P's right child.
Yeah. So now, if P is having P's left child, you simply print P's L child's data and enqueue P's L child. Okay. If your P is having right child, if P is having right child, what do you do? What do you do if P is having right child?
Print the right child data.
Right. So you simply print, I will just directly write printf, and I'll directly write P's R child's data. So I print 9, and what do? I enqueue that particular node. I enqueue that particular R child, P's R child, into the queue. Kalala ka hai sabranna?
Yes,
right?
Yes, ma'am.
So now your queue is something here. I'll just simply write 8. You have dequeued this, then you have 3. Now you have 9, right? Now again, you just check whether the queue is empty. No, then what you do? Now P will point to this particular part. So P will start pointing over here, right? Now you check if P is left child is there. Yes, it is having a left child. You simply print that left child and enqueue that particular node into the queue, right? Now check if it is having write child. No, it is not having write child. You simply don't do anything over there. Then what do you need to do? What do you need to do? Again, make dequeue this particular point. Now, so P will start pointing over here, right? So P will start pointing over here. Now, again, if P's left child is there, yes, it is there. You simply print that left child and enqueue this particular node that is 6 into the queue, right? So this process goes on while your queue is not empty, right? So this is dequeued, and then this particular process goes on till your queue is not empty. Samajla ka hai sagalyanna? Have you all understood this particular level order traversal using queue?
Yes, ma'am.
Those who have not understood, please raise your hands. So we will do this implementation during our lab. Aaj konachi lab hai? Which batch? I think so S4 na? S5. Okay. S5 is there. So which batch is free today? S3 is free, I think so. Right? S3 batch is free today?
Yes.
Okay, so S3 batch will join today. Okay. And today you all are going to implement this queue ADT of nodes, ADT queue of nodes and level order traversal. Have you all understood this level order traversal?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Okay. Now next is the implementation of a non-recursive. So some of the batches, I think the two batches, this particular part had got over, but I will complete it over here so that the traversal types and non-recursive implementation of the traversals are finished. And then we will see, can we generate a tree from the traversal given and then the search, okay? So, okay. Okay, so now this was your BFS implementation using queue or level order implementation using queue. Now let us see a BFS implementation that is either in order, pre-order or post-order kind of implementation using the stack of nodes. Okay, so we will see for a pre-order traversal, the same thing applies for your in-order and post-order also. So you can just try a non-recursive code for in-order and post-order later. Okay, I will explain for pre-order, then you can go for post-order. Okay, so let us consider a tree, a binary tree again, not a binary search tree. So this is a binary tree. Right. To implement a non-recursive pre-order traversal on a given tree, we will be making use of ADT stack. Right. We'll be making use of ADT stack, and this stack is of nodes. Right. So we all know that in recursive pre-order implementation, what do we do first in recursive pre-order implementation? If your tree equal to null, we assume that T is the root of your tree. If your T equal to null, you simply return, right? That is the base case for the recursion, right? Otherwise, what do you do if T is not equal to null? You first print in pre-order, you print T's data, then you recursively call pre-order on T's left child, and you recursively call pre-order on T's right child. Okay, so those who have not understood the recursion working, you can ask me in the lab sessions again. Okay, so this already I have taken in class, how recursively it calls each other, right, with the help of a recursion tree. Now using stack, this particular pre-order function, a non-recursive pre-order function, will require the pointer to the tree, that is node star T, right? It will require a stack of nodes, right? It will require a stack of nodes, right? So the first thing what you will do is you will have a stack of nodes also now. Okay, now if your T is not equal to null, the first thing is you are going to check if T is not equal to null, right? If your T is not equal to null, what do you do? The first thing you do in pre-order is you simply print, right? You simply print that particular data of the node, right? You simply print T's data, right? You simply print that T's data. Once you print the data, you push that node into the stack, because that is the node which we may require later to go to the next branch, right? You push that particular node into the stack. So what you are going to push? You're going to push T into the stack, and now make T point to T's left. So now, as we do not want to move this particular T here, so in this case this particular T might be local to this function, so won't make much difference, but you can make use of one more pointer if you don't want to move this particular reference T. You can make use of one more pointer, that is P, and then you keep on moving the P. Okay, now here I'm not doing that, I'm just directly using the pointer T over here. Okay, now make T point to T's left child, right? So T is pointing to T's left child now, right? So T is pointing to T's left child. So if T is not equal to null, right? T is not equal to null. This is the thing you need to do. So again, now what has happened is, again T is not equal to null. So you simply print that particular data and push that node into the stack. So I push that particular node into the stack and make T point to T's left child. So again, T is not equal to null. I print that particular data. I push this node into the stack. So I pushed this node into the stack and make T point to T's left child. So now T will start pointing to null, right? So if T is pointing to null, so that is the else part. So what do you need to do in the else part? Else, so you, this T's L child is not there. So in pre-order, what do we do is, you visit the root, then the left subtree, and then the right subtree, right? So now in this case, you have visited the root, that is 4, visited the left, that is its L child, but it is null. It might be having a right child, right? So it might be having a right child. So I want this T to go back, right? I want to this T to backtrack. So how do I get that particular address? How do I get that particular address? So if T equal to null now, in this case, I need to go back. So that is in the else part. What do I do is, how do I get back to this particular node? Yes?
We pop from the stack.
Right? I can pop the node from the stack. So which node will be popped? The node at the top of the stack will be popped. Right? The node at the top of the stack will be popped. So what is at the top of the stack? That is 4. So this is at 4. So if I pop the stack, the node from the stack, and I assign this particular address to T, so T will go back over here, right? If I say T equal to pop the node from the stack, so address of that node, I can make T point to that particular address, right? So once T has come over here, I will check for its R child. Then I will move T to T's R child, right? So now T has moved to T's R child. So what is T's, so this particular node has been popped out, okay? T's R child is again null. So this is not going to execute. So this particular point is going to get executed. So T's R child is null. So what do? You pop the node from the stack. So what is at the top of the stack? Top of the stack, we have a node that is 3. So 3 will be popped out from the stack and T will start pointing to that particular node. So now T will start pointing back over here. And then move T to T's R child. So move T to T's R child. So this has been done. Okay, now I have come over here. So T is not null. So you simply print the data that T is pointing to, push that node into the stack. So we have already popped 4 and 3, na? We have popped this 4 and 3. Now what we have to do is, now you push that 9 into the stack. So I'll simply push 9 into the stack, right? And make T point to T's L child. So T's L child is again null, right? T's L child is again null. So what do I do? This particular loop will not be executed. I'll have to go into the else part, right? It's not a loop. This particular condition will not be executed. I'll have to go into the else part. So what does else part say? You pop the node from the stack. So what is at the top of the stack? That is 9. So 9 will be popped, right? 9 will be popped and T will start pointing back to 9, right? T will start pointing back to 9. And now make T point to T's R child. T will start pointing to T's R child. That is null, right? So T is null again. You pop this particular node from the stack and make T start pointing back to that particular node. Okay, now T is pointing to 8. So T is not null, right? T is not null. So this particular T is, okay. And now you make T point to T's R child. So T's R child is 5, right? So now T is not null. You print the data, that is 5. You push this node into the stack. So your stack, fresh stack is, you have 5. Then, make T point to T's L child. So T's L child is, so T is pointing over here now. T's L child is 7. I hope everybody is understanding this.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so T's L child is 7 now. So T will start pointing over here, right? Now, what do you do is, T is not null. You simply print that data and push this node into the stack. This node is pushed into the stack and make T point to T's L child. So T is now pointing to null. So what you do is pop that particular node and make T point to this. So now T will start pointing back to 7. You have popped out this particular node, right? And make T point to T's R child. Now again, T's R child is null, right? So you again pop this particular node and make T point to that particular node. So T will start pointing back to 5, that is the popped node, and then T will start pointing to T's R child. T is over here. Now again, T is not equal to null. You print the data, push that node into the stack, make T point to null. So again, this is null. You pop this node, then T goes back here, then again to the right, and this is again null, right? Now, if it is null and stack is empty, so till when this particular process has to continue? Till your stack is not empty, right? Till your stack is not empty, because now when you're popping two, the stack is, after you pop two, the stack has become empty, right? That means that you have done everything, right? Till your stack is not empty, and your t is not equal to null, or your t is not equal to null, you keep on continuing this particular process. Have you all understood this? Have you all understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we will do this implementation of both this level order and non-recursive DFS traversal algorithms during our lab session. So today both the batches are going to join, that is S4 or S5, I think. So S5 and S3 batches going to join. Other batches, by that time, you can do it on yourself. And we will get it evaluated during the lab sessions. Okay, so next, today in the evening, again, I'm having your lecture. Yesterday's lecture, I'm compensating it. So 4:30, I think, so we'll be having the lecture. Okay, we'll have lecture at 4:30. During that lecture, I will cover your search. How do we search a node into a tree, and some extra